Vapour blasting, vapour honing, wet sandblasting, they're all the same thing. Today I'm going to show you how you can use a standard off-the-shelf domestic high-pressure washer to clean car parts like carburetors and nuts and bolts, and also to get paint off panels back to bare metal so that they're perfectly clean and ready to paint. Water sandblasting is a lot safer than dry sandblasting because there's not as much dust in the air. You can do it at home. Still recommend using glasses and a mask. But today I'm going to show you the bits that you need to connect with your standard high pressure washer, and let's get stuck in and actually clean up some bits. So this is what I'm using. It's just a Gerni 130.3 standard domestic washer, and it's connected to my standard Gerni handpiece, which instead of going to the Gerni extension, which is here, we actually just go straight into this lance. So this has a connector on the end, which is called a nilfisk connector, which goes straight into there. And this is the part that you can buy. Check out the link below. It goes straight into this piece, which is the nozzle, blaster nozzle, and the sand gets sucked in through here. I've got the sand coming from my little sandblaster, which was pretty ineffective for blasting components. I'm just really using it as a storage tank for the sand. But this cape, this hose can just go straight to the pipe that comes with the actual nozzle, and you can just put that straight into a bucket of sand. So I can either connect this hose to something like this, or I can connect the hose to here to get my sand supply. I'm using washed, filtered, dry sand, which gets sucked down here into the nozzle, sprayed out with the water, and it gives a really good result. So here are the results after a bit of high pressure washing. This is pretty quick, really nice finish. I might have to rough that up a little bit before I put primer on it, but you can see it works really great. Took the paint off, which was multiple layers of paint, pretty easily. It's really good for getting into these hard to reach areas. Uses a lot of sand, so I found that that's a really nice finish. For small components, fantastic. But for large surfaces like this, you might want to just get into the nooks and crannies and difficult parts and then use a normal paint removing wheel or disc to get the rest off, because it uses, I think I used about 20 kilograms of sand in about 10 minutes. So it uses a lot of sand, but does a really good job. We'll just look on the other side. So you can see the difference here. Rusty old surface with paint and rust flake and that sort of thing. Really nice, smooth surface after it's been blasted. This is my old rusty section of door panel, and you'll see at the top where I've blasted it, really nice and clean. And that was really just 10 seconds worth of blasting. And underneath too, where I did a little bit of blasting.
After you've blasted something with the water and sand mixture, it's really important to blow it all off dry. I'm just using an airline on an air compressor, but you could use hair dryer to dry the thing off. It's a good idea to paint it pretty soon after blasting it, because you're taking it back to bare metal and you'll get flash rust pretty quickly. If you do get flash rust, you can always clean that off with some water and vinegar, and that will help you neutralize the rust. And yes, then you'll be ready to paint and you'll have a really nice, clean, back to bare metal panel. So check it out.